In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Rose of Lima. This Mass is offered for all the souls in the purgatory. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You lock the kingdom of heaven before men, you do not enter yourselves, nor do you allow entrance to those trying to enter. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You traverse sea and land to make one convert, and when that happens to you, make him a child of Gehenna, twice as much as yourselves. Woe to you, blind guides, who say, 'If one swears by the temple, it means nothing, but if one swears by the wall of the temple, one is obligated.' Blind fools, which is greater, the wall or the temple that make the wall sacred? And you say, 'If one swears by the altar, it means nothing, but if one swears by the gift on the altar, one is obligated.' You blind ones, which is greater, the gift or the altar that makes the gift sacred? One who swears by the altar swears by it and all that is upon it. One who swears by the temple swears by it and by him who dwells in it. One who swears by heaven swears by the throne of God and by him who is seated on it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. The first reading is from the first letter of St. Paul to Thessalonians, which was written around 50 to 51 AD by St. Paul in Corinth. It is the very first New Testament letter written by St. Paul in the churches. The opening session we have on today is filled with encouragement, gentleness, and love of St. Paul. When St. Paul sees that God is walking among the Thessalonians, the first early Christian community in Thessalonica, it is in the modern town between trade to east and west. And he prays them for their work of faith, giver of love, and endurance in hope of Jesus Christ. Sometimes we need to encourage and to see the grace of God working in other people, because sometimes we in our weakness we forget that our faith, hope, and love grow each day by the grace of God. For example, when we get to the Mass early daily Mass, when you seek one another, then in the Mass pray for the needs of the world, and even before the Mass say the Rosary and the Holy Mass, you are encouraged by their faith, hope, and love, and you see the grace of God is working in other people. Similarly, we can see that our grandparents or brothers and sisters at home say the Rosary together, come to the church together, working hard for the family and for giving each other, being patient with one another. All these are acts of our faith and hope, and we encourage one another by our action. In today's Gospel, Jesus cautions us not to focus on the exterior of services, but in our relationship with our Lord. This relationship we can see in one another, and we Let us gather our prayers before our loving God. For all the leaders of the Church, may they be ministers of healing and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the nations, may they be sources of justice and peace for all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace, may it be granted to all in battle of war, violence, and fear throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all ministers of the gospel, may they be strengthened and guided in the fulfillment of their ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of life, sacred from the moment of conception to death of natural death, a God-given right, may we always give thanks. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, especially for the souls in the purgatory, may Jesus welcome them soon to eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for a moment for our special intention. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever-loving God, we ask you to hear all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
In the Lord, send sacrifice to your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of the Holy Church.
As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin Saint Rose of Lima, we humbly implore your majesty that as our merits are pleasing to you, so do our dutiful service. May find favor in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ, for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its origin and holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promised in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God. Blessed be he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. In a similar way, when Sabbath was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Let us pray. Renew by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of St. Rose of Lima, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to Him alone. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with the Spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God with your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Say my God.